research. It is a two-day activity which brings together senior professionals in media organizations across Nigeria. It was good that we had the introduction. We must have seen that by sponsor from all regions of this country. Selection for this activity has given attention to the diversity of the broadcast media industry, as well as the diversity of the country itself. And to facilitate the activity, we have also brought a team of experienced professionals. The activity itself is a part of the support to media component of the project titled EU Support to Democratic Governance in Nigeria. It's a project that's running for 4 years and a few months. Funded by the European Union. So you can see that it was starting a journey, you know, that's so first of all, it took 4 years and a few months, and then that we go beyond that period. In short, we just call it EU-SDGM. The EU-SDGM project seeks to reinforce democracy in Nigeria. It seeks to strengthen democratic governance through improving the capacity of democratic institutions. Hence, in this project, one will find components which support such institutions as INEC, which support INEC, National Assembly, political parties, the media, and civil society. Activities are currently ongoing in all the components. Immediate focus on the 2019 general elections in Nigeria. The support to media component has an important objective. This objective that we want to achieve is for the media to provide a fair, accurate, and ethical coverage of the electoral process, particularly going into 2019. Outputs are to be delivered in 4 areas to achieve this objective. Area 1, that's the first area, strengthening media professionalism, or strengthening building the capacity, or improving the capacity of media professionals to achieve, or for media professionalism. Second area, improving the capacity of media platforms to diversify and deepen civic and voter education. The third area, to enhance the capacity of the media regulator to perform its mandate. And the fourth area, to strengthen media attention to promoting the participation of marginalized groups in the electoral process and in politics in general. Our organization, the Institute for Media and Society, has responsibility for implementation in this support to media company. As you all know, the media has very important roles to play in the electoral process. Among other roles, it's expected to give voice to the various political institutions which are involved in the process. It is expected also to inform and educate citizens so that they can make informed choices during elections. And to function appropriately in the process to perform these roles, the media must have necessary capacity. More than ever, it has become urgent for the media in Nigeria to improve its capacity to enable it to do up-to-date engagement of the electoral process. I know that within us, we know how things went in 2015. And as professionals, as core stakeholders in the industry, we want things to be better in 2019 and beyond. This is why we are here. This audience research training is one of the earliest activities in the support to media component. It is to equip the media to understand the audience and needs, and then provide improved programming. Meaning that it is fundamental to the work of developing or improving professionalism. How will this go? This work, I will get to participants at this training will acquire knowledge and skills. There is no doubt about that. And returning to our various organizations, we will step down in training. That is the acquired knowledge and skills. So I said it's a journey that we're going into. We are not just there to take the training, but we will acquire the knowledge and skills. It's the second step. Will be to step down the trade in our various organizations. Each station will organize actual audience research activities and report back. That's step three. We have in place a follow-up arrangement which will be unfolded as stations carry out their audience research activities. So you can see that the journey is going on and on and on, working together to build capacity. And I'm happy that you are a part of this from the very beginning. So you now, I'm sure you now begin to understand why in the letters that we sent to your various stations, we said we want people, professionals who are sufficiently senior. For people who have been in this business for a long time and who will appreciate the importance of this kind of training, who find it easy to understand.